From the 1st of September, it was made EU law that vacuum cleaners can now be no more powerful than 900 watt. From now on, if I say the word hoover, I mean vacuum cleaner. In the UK, we call vacuum cleaners hoovers. And if we're hoovering, it vacuum cleaning. Okay, so if I say hoover, that's what I mean. So, what this means is once again, we're going to get a whole range of products that are going to get winning awards and saying, yeah, these are brilliant, when in fact, they're a load of tats. There's so much tats that is labelled as energy efficient and wins awards and everything. And it's rubbish. A great example I can give is in an episode of Dragon's Den when Peter Jones shot down this computer manufacturer who had won all these awards and had all these claims that his energy efficient computers are the best thing in the world, better than IBM and this, that and the other. And Peter Jones was like, actually, you're more environmentally friendly as a carrier bag, because it turns out the system was rubbish. You know what I mean? Let's get back onto vacuum cleaners. Okay, what's going to happen is, because there's no incentive for vacuum cleaner manufacturers to improve their rovers, you know, all that's going to happen is the carpet beater will probably spin faster and probably be more aggressive on surfaces, causing more wear and tear. There's no incentive there. It's just stupidity, really. Look at the state of light bulbs. I think it's CFL, as you call them in America, energy saving light bulbs, which were just like fluorescent tubes wiggled round and you plug them into your lights and whatnot. They were awful. Many people with illnesses like migraines and other issues had trouble with them, and same with LEDs, you know, they keep you awake. And the light from them is usually quite awful, especially street lights. If you live on a street with LED street light, and it's awful, innit? They're just changing hours around here now. And before, there used to be this nice glow so you could see everything around you, like the normal orangey sort of glow or whitish sort of glow. Now what you've got is this shadowy little beam of light which just highlights the circle on the floor. Yet you could look next to you and it's just total darkness. It's rubbish. What I really get really hit up about is stuff that's called energy efficient and this is progress when it clearly isn't. The next thing they want to move on to is kettles. So, by taking energy away from kettles, by making kettles less powerful, it doesn't mean it's more energy efficient. You just kind of have that kettle on longer, heating up the water. And I always put in the right amount of water for what I need anyway. I mean, you've seen me so many times make a cup of tea, make a cup of coffee, and you know that I only put in as much water as I need, a very small amount. So my kettle will take probably about 20 to 30 seconds to boil the water that I need. A lot of people are not, obviously. A lot of people fill that kettle right to the top, wait about 5 minutes for it to boil, use a little bit, put it back, then boil that water again, pour, boil, pour, boil, pour. You know, by making kettles less powerful, that's just not going to make them obviously pay more money, but me as well. So it's stupid. You're not making it more energy efficient. And coming back onto hoovers, I can just think now of like someone walking into a pub one day and going, getting harassed by some sort of crook, you know, going, all right, mate, yeah, I've got you a 1,500 watt hoover here, mate. Yeah, mate. Yeah, turn it on, mate, turn it on. If you turn this on now, mate, I tell you, the old pub will end up inside it, mate. Yeah, the entire pub will end up in this, mate. Yeah. That's what I've got. Just dropped it, shit. Don't want to break that. Don't want a crappy over repairing this good one. Well, that's my reaction. Let me know in the comment section down below, what do you think? Is it a good thing? Do you like energy-saving products? Do you think they are actually energy efficient? I mean, what next? Fans? I mean, I've constantly got a fan on. Is some EU law going to come in and say,
actually, the British, they have very powerful fans. They don't cool the air down, they just recirculate the air. I think we should put on a limit to the revolutions of the fan blades to 1 per second.
I'm not really sure what accent that was, but it was an accent of some description. It's just not going to stop, is it? Everything's getting crapper. Everything's getting crapper in the name of environmentally friendliness. Anyway, let me know in the comment section down below if I'm right or if I'm wrong. Let me know. Maybe I'm just old-fashioned. Thanks for watching. Bye.